Hi, good morning, and thank you for tuning in with me on letsthinkaloud.com. What a day today. Actually, a very beautiful morning as I wait for my interview with this very stunning lady. I'm amazed at how far her project, Samarpana, the Asian Festival of Classical Dance, has really come. The beauty behind the brains of the festival, she's also the founder of Shruti Laya Dance School in Singapore, and I have her here with me for all of you. Some of us who are still contemplating buying the tickets to the festival yet, let's hear it from the woman, Miss Gayatri Sriram, what Samarpana 2015 this time is all about. Hi Gayatri.
Hi Himani, thanks for having me on the show.
Thank you for joining me yet again. It was a pleasure to have you the last time, and we're actually talking after a year.
Yes, we are actually.
I know. So let's quickly move on to Samarpana. Firstly, my very first question, we had interviewed you last year for Samarpana 2014 as well. And this year, I know the lineup is fabulous. So what would you say? How different is Samarpana 2014 to 2015?
For one, I think, you know, being the fourth year and being in collaboration with the Esplanade, The venue itself lends a great deal of credibility to the project. Esplanade is synonymous with outstanding quality. Esplanade is synonymous with innovative act, and Esplanade is synonymous with people and arts,
right?
The synergy between those two. So for us, having this unique collaboration itself, having that vote of confidence itself, has boosted the morale of the festival and has made us believe that this festival does count. It is something that we had aspired to have on the Singapore cultural calendar, and it has made that. So yes, that is one big difference. Difference in terms of the lineup. Himani, our lineup was phenomenal last year, as we tend to want to bring acts that are very different, very innovative, very out of the box, and yet do not traverse what is meant to be seen within the grammar or the perspective of that particular classical dance. Even in contemporary, we try to bring in acts that are stunning acts within what could be qualified as contemporary dance. We want to bring a certain sense of excellence throughout our acts. Our acts were brilliant last year, our acts are brilliant this year. We have some slight differences. For example, we are we have an artist in residence this year. So we have Kalpana Raghuraman from The Hague, Netherlands, who is coming in and training Singaporean dancers to create a production through the eyes of my city as our tribute to SG50. This particular production will also go abroad next year to The Hague. So we have created a chance this year for Singaporean dancers to audition, be picked out, and then be taken to The Hague. So that itself is a new for us. We have Akash Odedera, who is the great Akram Khan student and is making phenomenal waves in the field of dance. He's a BESI award winner, and he's presenting The Rising. So that is a huge feather in our cap, bringing Akash Odedera into our festival. I don't think he's performed in Singapore before.
Lovely.
That's a first for us. And our opening night is always about collaboration. So we have with us Kavita Krishnamurti and Sujata Mohapatra in Odissi. Both need or require absolutely no introduction. Phenomenal artists. And so that confluence is going to bring a great amount of verve into each other's genre. You know, they're sharing that space. And we hope that confluence is going to be something very new, something very path-breaking. Apart from that, we also have the Singapore Indian Orchestra. We have a faction of that orchestra called Lalitanjali in a collaboration with Shijit and Parvati Nambiar of Kalakshetra. And we have already presented this piece in Bangalore. So this is the second presentation in Samarpana Singapore. That is Ananya Samarpana India. So that again is a cross-border production. So all in all, we are trying to bring in pieces that mean something. As an emerging artist, we are presenting Meenakshi Venkatraman, who's a student of Shruti Laya. And she is going to present her first production thematically. We have some incredible dance and music presentations. But over and above that, we have a panel discussion, which is very meaningful for dancers today who wonder about the difference between the evocative and the provocative.
Mm-hmm.
We also have the great Devdutt Patnaik,
mm-hmm.
who's a best-selling author. So yes, we have an excellent lineup and are proud to present this.
Brilliant. In fact, when I was going through the lineup, that it's always a beautiful and brilliant amalgamation and collaboration that you have of various artists and dancers and speakers. But what really brought to my notice was Devdutt Patnaik. I want to ask you, in the lineup, he really stands out. So how did you plan to rope in Devdutt Patnaik for a panel discussion?
Devdutt Patnaik is one of my favorite authors. I was introduced to him by my guru,
mm-hmm.
Srimati Meenal Prabhu, who is one of the brains behind Samarpana itself. When Jyoti and I and Minalakka began this journey, there were certain things that we all three wanted to bring in. Minalakka and I have been doing a lot with regards to the programming, and Jyoti has been part of the entire management, pulling the strings together, contacting the artists. So yes, three of us really formed the backbone of Samarpana.
Right.
Minalakka introduced me to Devdutt Patnaik with his first book, Jaya, about the Mahabharata, and I was hooked.
Mm-hmm.
This year, past 3 years, we've had a brilliant speaker, Mr. Sriram Venkatakrishnan from India.
Mm-hmm.
And he is a heritage speaker. He is outstanding in terms of his capability of bringing heritage, Bharatanatyam, you know, the history of dance. He's an historian. This year, we decided that we wanted to bring in a gentleman who could give an angle of fiction about stories behind the myths that all of us dancers use in Bharatanatyam or any other Indian classical dance form. That is why we sort of pinned down on Mr. Devdutt Patnaik. And, you know, we are all such great fans of his work in presenting the ancient legends in a very different way is quite path-breaking. He's going to talk on a very novel a subject called Why Do We Dance as Menaka, Mohini or Mahesh?
Mm-hmm.
So it has something for the layperson who is a reader who wants to know more about Indian mythology presented in a very different form.
Certainly, certainly looking forward to this piece.
Absolutely,
at Samarpana.
Absolutely.
So there's another thing about Samarpana. We've always had artists and talent coming into Singapore, but what we also notice is now a lot of local talent you guys have been sending out of Singapore to perform.
Clearly.
What about this outflow of talent? How did this begin, and you know, where do you plan to take this?
When we began Samarpana, the first year in Singapore, you know, over a conversation with my guru, we came up with the idea that, you know, it's such a beautiful festival, it needs to definitely cross the border, go to India. So
mm-hmm.
first chapter, she put me in touch with a very great patron of the arts in Bangalore called Mr. Raghavendra. He's a scientist, but one of the greatest art promoters.
Mm-hmm.
And he runs an organization called Ananya.
Okay.
So we tied up. It became Ananya Samarpana. Under the guidance of my guru, a lot of choreographed presentations that involved Singaporean dancers, some of my students, and dancers like Zaini Tahir and his group went into productions that were transported into India. Apart from that, we also had theatrical and dance productions like Dhara, which was presented last year,
mm-hmm.
which involved the entire theatrical component from Singapore, some amount of dancers from Singapore, to move to India to present this production.
Okay.
This year, we have actually decided that we must also show Singaporean dancers in other parts of the world.
Mm-hmm.
So we brought in this whole concept of Through the Eyes of My City with Kalpana Raghuraman,
right,
who is coming here to choreograph with the Singaporean dancers, and then take this production to the Netherlands at Corso Theatre, The Hague. And it becomes part of their festival there. So automatically, we take Singaporean dancers into a different paradigm and give them an opportunity to be part of that festival. It also catapults Samarpana into a level whereby people perceive Samarpana as a venture that allows them to travel. I think we're opening up very different opportunities, very novel opportunities for Singaporean artists to be seen abroad.
That's beautiful. In fact, it's fascinating for most of the local talent here to also go and perform somewhere outside of Singapore. So it's Absolutely. A brilliant opportunity.
We want productions that are multiracial, that are multi-talented, multi-genre. And that is our entire motto behind Samarpana.
You speak as impeccably as you dress or look.
Oh,
gorgeous.
Thank you. That's very, very sweet.
So for all those of us who are still contemplating buying the tickets, some of us have bought some shows, some of us haven't bought other highlights. What do you want to say to all the listeners tuned in right now listening to you? Why should they come to Samarpana?
Samarpana really is a venture, is a production, is a platform, is a festival of the arts. If you want to experience arts in a very different way, see different people, meet artists, historians, critics, thinkers, innovators, then Samarpana is where you should be. Samarpana is a three-day festival with outstanding artists performing, bringing out premieres of productions that have not been seen before because we facilitate them. Mm-hmm. It's also a place where you enter, you see a completely new world, you see back-to-back performances and leave the Esplanade completely in tune with the arts, in tune with a different paradigm, in tune with a different universe. So come and experience it, because we present various acts that are going to really capture your imagination.
Lovely. August 21st to 23rd is Samarpana 2015. Make sure all of you book your tickets. And thank you so much, Gayatri, for talking to
thank
us.
Thank you very much, Himani. Tickets are at SISTIC and they're out there. Please, please, come and watch Samarpana.
Definitely will. Thank you.
Thank you very much.